Hello, good morning. I will introduce myself as Dr. Chetan DM, working as Associate Professor in the Department of Biotechnology. I am going to take some topics in biology for the engineers subject. So before proceeding to the actual topic, just let us discuss why this particular subject introduced for engineering streams. See, this subject introduced few years back, maybe 6 years or 7 years. When they introduced this particular subject, biology for engineers, especially for first year students, we all hesitated first initially. How engineering students accept this particular subject? Because some of you are not, may not be studied the biology subject in PU level. You are not, some of you are not interested in biology field. And then afterwards, IIT people's expertise, professors, they conducted a workshops conference in biology for engineering subject, and then they informed why they intended to introduce this particular subject for engineering students. The reason is many things are happening in nature, right? Many beautiful things are happening in nature, right? See, that those exciting phenomena we can incorporate in our engineering principle to create wonders. Sir, for example, what, sir? For example, aeroplane. Analogy is bird, right? That person used that analogy in order to design aeroplanes. One example, termite. So many examples are, classical examples are available in nature in which engineers use that particular concepts to design the things. And another side, you have to, if you understand the body system, life, then if there is any lacuna is there, and through your stream, you can overcome those particular disorders. So, for example, what, sir? See, for example, best example is pacemaker. How they introduce, why they introduce pacemakers? Because the person's heartbeat, it won't generate electric signals. Some engineers understand that particular lacuna. So they can create artificially the design in which it compensates, produces electric signals. Dialysis machine, what is there in dialysis machine? It filters the blood. Kidney filters the blood. The same thing they designed artificially as dialysis machine. So that if the person is suffering from any disorder with regard to kidney, and then the blood is drawn out from that person and it is reaches that machine, and that machine purifies the blood, and then once again that is returned to the system. This is just one example. Conversion of seawater into potable water, right? Another example, beautiful example. Likewise, numerous examples are available just to trigger your curious to study what is happening in the nature. For that reason, not to trigger, in order to increase your interest, they introduce this particular subject, biology for engineers. It looks why it is waste, but in depth, if you understand this one, you can achieve a tremendous phenomenon. You can achieve a lot. So why they introduce in first year? Then we ask why first year, in the IIS semester, you can introduce this particular subject. The first year means, if you understand this one, if you are constantly, if you are searching for the phenomenon, what is happening, then you can, when you are studying the engineering aspects, you can incorporate. You can create wonders. That possibility is there. So not only this particular subject, not only for examination point of view, don't study. Just if you understand why to see the consequences happening in the nature, if you understand that particular statement, then the purpose of this particular subject is solved. Okay, let us discuss the first topic, human excretory system. In that human excretory system, I am going to discuss the role of kidney in the formation of urine. First we'll see urine is kidney. A kidney is consisting of a pair of kidneys. Human excretory system consists of a pair of kidneys, ureters, urinary bladder, and urethra. All this constitutes human excretory system. But in your syllabus, they are mainly concentrated on kidneys. See, if you look the structure of the kidneys, it is mainly consisting of nearly 1 million nephrons, units of kidney. That unit of kidney is referred as nephron. See in this diagram, beautiful diagram, whatever you are seeing, this is the structure of nephron. nephron are the structural and functional units of kidney. So it is referred as structural and functional unit of kidney. And each nephron is consisting of two parts. One is referred as glomerulus. See this here you are finding, right, the red mark, red. This one is referred as glomerulus, and then the tubular like structure. This is tubular like structure is referred as renal tubules. Okay, it consisting of two parts. See, whatever the features, the important features I am discussing also in between, that remember for MCQ questions, the blood plasma in kidney is filtered at about 150 to 200 liters per day. What about the capacity of kidney? Kidney is filtered where the blood plasma, it reaches kidney, right? In kidney, it is filtered at about 150 to 200 liters per day. 150 to 200 liters per day, remember. And then if you look glomerulus, that individual parts we are discussing, right? Glomerulus, it is having afferent arteriole. This one is referred as afferent arteriole, and this one is referred as efferent arteriole. Tuft of capillary is formed by afferent arteriole. Okay, and blood from the glomerulus is carried away by afferent arteriole. Then blood from it reaches glomerulus, and then it is carried away. Blood has to be carried away once again, right? And that is carried away by afferent arteriole. And then renal tubule, renal tubule begins with double walled cup-like Bowman's capsule. This one you are noticing, right? Where actually the renal tubule starts? Renal tubule starts in this region, that is referred as Bowman's capsules. Okay, glomerulus plus Bowman's capsule is referred as Malpighian body system. And this one is a renal tubule. Once again, they shown this diagram, and it is having many nephrons open and tight collecting. This one is finally urine collected at collecting duct. Okay, and then how actually urine is formed? Urine formation, physiology of kidney, we have already studied, right? See, the urinary system is also known as the renal system. They asked in MCQ question, urinary system, you can mention it as a renal system is nothing but the urinary system. Okay, and Bowman's capsule of kidney contains the cells that is referred as podocytes. Here you can notice podocytes. Podocytes, where actually it contains, it is present in Bowman's capsule. Okay, podocytes, that is an important aspects. And then urine formation involves three steps, processes of urine formation. One is glomerular filtration, second one is reabsorption, and third one is tubular secretion. What happens in these three steps? Let us discuss. In case of glomerular filtration, almost all constituents of blood across plasma except the protein pass into the lumen of Bowman's capsule. So when blood rushes to the kidney, it filters. Okay, about this year, about 1,100 to 2,200 ml of blood is filtered by kidneys per minute. Okay, it constitutes one by fifth of the blood pumped out by each ventricle of the heart in a minute. Means 1,100 to 2,200 ml of blood is filtered by kidney per minute. Just think the capacity of this particular organ. And then that rate is referred as glomerular filtration rate. Okay, normal glomerular filtration rate is 125 ml per minute. That is what 180 liter per day. But remember, whatever it is filtered, that is not comes converted into an urine. So just imagine if 180 liters per day, if it's whatever it is absorbed into kidney, if it is all it's excreted, you can't imagine the survivability of living organisms, right? So luckily, once again, whatever it is filtered 180 liters per day, get reabsorbed. Okay, that is referred as, the step is referred as reabsorption. So 180 liters of glomerular filtrate is produced daily, but 99% of this is reabsorbed by renal tubules. See here. Means 99% of 180 liters in the sense, nothing but it almost it comes under in and around values, that is 1.5 liters. Okay. So what actually the things are reabsorbed? We need glucose, because during that absorption, vital elements, whatever nutrients, whatever we are mentioning, glucose, amino acids, sodium, etc., are all absorbed. But once again, it has to be reabsorbed. If it is lost from body system, you can't imagine the life survivability of life more than 3 days for a person, right? So all the vital elements once again gets reabsorbed. Passive reabsorption of water occurs in the initial segments of nephron. Here takes place once again in the diagram. So you see here reabsorption glucose, some acid, sodium, etc. gets reabsorbed. See, due to in this diagram they mentioned, see here, afferent vacuole, filtration from blood plasma into the nephron takes place, here, first step, absorption, and then second step, tubular reabsorption from fluid into blood, reabsorption takes place. Whatever the vital elements are present here in the form of urine, once again get reabsorbed, okay, and then once again that urine becomes thick, because tubular secretion from blood into the fluid, blood is here, the blood, okay, in this, from this blood, some unnecessary elements, unnecessary elements gets secrete into urine, so that urine becomes concentrated, and then that urine contains excreted substance, and this reaches distal tubule or collecting tubule. Via collecting tubule, it eliminates. Okay, cells of acidity and acidity maintain ionic sodium potassium balance and acid base balance, pH of the body fluids, by selective secretion of hydrogen potassium. It's actually balance is there, maintain ionic balance, okay, into the filtrate and absorption of hydrogen carbonate from it. Collecting duct maintains pH and ionic balance of blood by secretion of hydrogen and potassium ions. So remember, see here, absorption takes place, here deabsorption, tubular absorption, glomerular absorption, tubular reabsorption, and tubular secretion. These are three steps are taking place in the formation of urine. Okay. See, for the renal glucose carriers, saturation occurs when the concentration of glucose in the blood is about 180 mg per 200 ml of blood. When actually the saturation takes place? The saturation takes place when 180 mg per 200 ml of blood happens. Very, very important phenomenon. Internally, both kidneys have three distinct regions. What are the regions? The cortex, medulla, and pelvis. These are three regions present internally in both kidneys. Three distinct regions of kidneys includes cortex, medulla, and pelvis. The effect of antidiuretic hormone influences on the kidney is to increase the permeability of distal nephron to water. But it has to be have that particular capacity to absorb. That is happening by the influence of the hormone that is referred as antidiuretic hormone, nothing but ADH. Which one is not a nitrogenous waste? This is one of another important parameter feature. Theanine is not comes under the category of nitrogenous waste. Okay, another two important concepts to remember in regard to this urine formation and the role of kidney. Proton in regard to other class of organisms. Protoniperidia and metaniperidia, these are the two common terminology you have to understand. Protoniperidia means it is composed of many flame cells that are ciliated cells used in excretion. It is not having any internal well-organized organs in some animals, some organisms. Through ciliated cells, the ciliated cells involve excretion. Those comes under the category of protoniperidia. And metaniperidia means composed of very particular organ gland system. Composed of cells that have an internal opening known as nephrostome and an external opening known as nephridophore. Those organisms come under the category of metaniperidia. Okay, see, the nitrogenous waste disposal system of flat forum. If you look flat forum, it is an example for protoniperidia. And specialized excretory cell found in flat forum is flame bulb. And then which actually the excretory cells, the name of excretory cells found in flat form, that is referred as flame bulb. In a sense, just we are not supposed to discuss what is happening, how kidney takes the role in excretory organs, takes the role in the formation of urine in all organisms, not possible to discuss. So we took some examples. In case of protoniperidia, flat form, protoniperidia mode of kidney elimination, in flat form, protoniperidia mode of elimination is taking place, and in case of flat form, that specialized excretory cell is referred as the flame bulb, and the nitrogenous waste disposes of the system of annelids, another class of organism, their metaniperidia. Metaniperidia in the sense, very particular gland system, organ system is there, particular system is there, in which because of that particular system, elimination takes place. Okay, the nitrogenous waste disposal system of arthropod is Malthusian tubules. Malthusian tubules is examples for nitrogenous waste disposal system of arthropod. I hope you understand the concept of the role of kidney in the formation of urine. Thank you. Thank you.